Hello everyone, this is Prajwal Verma from MSVD Aspirants. As many of you have been asking us on Instagram, sir, how can we join Merchant Navy? It's a very important question for the young aspirants to know. And for those who have taken other subjects than PCM in their 11th, 12th and doing something else like arts or humanities or commerce or other programs in the further education too. Okay. So we decided to make a detailed video on this particular topic so that we can explain you things very, very easily. As we all know, it is very difficult to explain things on chats. So let's get started with today's video. Before starting, we will divide Merchant Navy jobs into two parts. First of all, most popular ways to join Merchant Navy. Second of all, less popular ways to join Merchant Navy. In the most popular ways to join Merchant Navy, there are three sites: deck side, engine side, and there is ETU. Okay, I don't know, electrical side, you can say that. Less popular jobs. Okay, there is crew and cooking and all the department, and there is rigging department, the fitters and the bosuns and all. Okay, so let's get started with most popular ways to join Merchant Navy. In the most popular ways to join Merchant Navy, we'll first discuss engine side. Okay. So let's get started with engine side. In engine side, there are three ways to join. Okay, first is to do VTEC Marine Engineering. Second is to do GME. Third is to do Diploma in Marine Engineering. And you know, do the same. It's a lot of different process. But Diploma in Marine Engineering is little different from VTEC in Marine Engineering. As you know, Diploma is 3-year course and VTEC is 4-year course. I will explain it later, okay, so don't worry about it. Before starting all the things, let me explain what is the function of engine side ownership. The engine side is a group of people who maintain the functioning of the machinery on the ship, like engine, pump, valves, propeller, and all the machinery that is very, very important for the proper functioning of a ship. Let's first discuss with the first approach to join engine side, that is VTEC in Marine Engineering. First of all, we will discuss the eligibility criteria to do VTEC in Marine Engineering. The eligibility criteria that we will discuss is very common, okay, because it might vary from place to place, but this one was very, very common at every place, because some might ask for some other things, but this was the very common thing that I found on all the colleges and universities. Okay. So the thing is, you have to have 60% aggregate in PCM and more than 50% marks in your 10th or 12th, okay, either one of them. You can have 50% marks in English in your 10th or no. Or in 12th, if you have less than 50% in 10th, you can score more in your 12th in English so that you get eligible. Okay, this might change. Okay, some colleges might have for 65%, some 75%, but the basic was here to at least have 60% and have PCM in your 12th. Okay, PCM is compulsory and having English is also compulsory. Okay, so the next thing is your age should be minimum 17. And maximum 25 for general category students. For OBC, minimum 17 to maximum 28 year olds. Okay, for SCST student, you have to have minimum age of 17 and maximum age of 30, and you can add 2 years if you are female. Okay, so these are the basic eligibility criteria to join VTEC Marine Engineering. There is also physical criteria that you have to fulfill. If you want to know about that, let us know in the comment section or just Google it. Okay, it's a very small DG approved doctor list. Okay, they will, if you contact them, they will let you know all the details. After completing your VTEC Marine Engineering, you can join ship. You know, it's not that easy. You have to apply for jobs and all, and if you get selected, you will get hired by the companies and they will let you know when the ships are free and you will join the ships and you will proceed on your career. Okay, and in Merchant Navy, it's very common to give exams for each promotion. Okay, when you get promoted, you have to give the exams so you can promote yourself and have a better career. So let's talk about the second approach to join engine side. That is GME, Graduate Marine Engineer. So eligibility criteria here is to have minimum 50% aggregate in your 4 year of BTEC. Okay, let's talk about BTEC. What kind of branches are eligible? Mechanical engineering is eligible. Then there is automation is eligible, naval architecture is eligible. All those branches are eligible where mechanical engineering syllabus is major section, like 70% or 60% syllabus should be mechanical engineering, and rest can change a little bit. There can be electrical, there can be electronics, there can be some other things, okay, but mechanical section should be major. Those are the branches that will be eligible for GME. Your percentage in your 4 year of engineering should be 50% minimum, and your college should be approved by AICTE. And for English, you have to have minimum 50%, okay, either in your 10th or in your 12th, okay. Like if you have less in 10th, you can score more in 12th, so you don't have to worry about it. If you are doing your engineering, please make sure you don't fail, okay. Just have a good percentage, 50, they have set eligibility criteria 50, but some companies will ask for 60, 65, okay, I will explain it by the end, okay. Let's first of all focus all on the options, and in the end I will let you know how to get a job easily, or what are the things that you should really focus on right now so that you don't have as much as problem as other students after they complete their graduation or 10th or 12th. Okay, so as I have already discussed, the GME physical eligibility criteria is same as, or medical eligibility criteria is same as, you know, BTEC Marine Engineering, so there is no difference in that. So let's start with the third approach to join engine side, that is doing diploma in marine engineering. It is not very popular, but you know, as I have discussed, engine side, joining engine side is very very popular. So doing diploma in marine engineering is not very popular, not very safe these days, because you know, everything has changed. If you want to know about diploma in marine engineering, just Google it. NUSI is one of the best colleges for this. NUSI Goa, okay, it is a good college to diploma in marine engineering. It is a little bit different from BTEC in marine engineering, because you have a 3 year course and a 4 year course, and that you have to sail more to become as same as this, okay. You will find it all the details on Google, because I don't have much idea about this one, but this is one of the career options that you can choose to join Merchant Navy. But this is one of the education qualifications that you can have and join ship on the engine side, okay. Now let's move on to ETO. ETO are the group of people who deal with the electrical devices on the ship. So let's talk about the eligibility criteria of ETO. This is not a fixed, this might change from company to company, but it will give you a basic idea what are the degrees you have to join ETO, okay. So first of all, you have to have a 60% PCM aggregate in your 12th, 50% in English either in 10th or 12th, and have a BTEC degree or a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering, electronics engineering, electrical and electronics engineering, telecommunication engineering, and any other branch of engineering that have electrical as a major subject. Like 50 to 60% of the subjects are electrical engineering subjects, okay. You can say the core subject of that branch is electrical engineering. So this is the basic, and the aggregate that you should have maintained in your BTEC should be 50%, but I would suggest to have at least 75 to 76% as an aggregate in your BTEC, so that when you apply in the different companies to become a ETO, or you know, in colleges to complete the ETO course, as the competition is growing, many people are applying for this job, so you have to have good marks so that you can have an upper hand over others. So this is the basic eligibility criteria. There is one more way, but there is no proper information available on the internet, so I will just leave you some hints. That is, if you have a diploma with 60% aggregate, you can also become an ETO. For the proper information, please contact with the specific institutes and companies, okay. But on the websites, their phone number are available, emails are available. Do contact them. If you are a diploma student, you will get a way how to join SHIP or you know, ETO courses, okay. After completing your ETO course, you have to give your exams, and before even applying for ETO, you have to give some exams so that you can join an ETO course, and you know, it's a certificate kind of course, so it's a small course. You have to give the entrance exam, interview, and you have to do the course, and after that you have to give entrance exam and interview to apply for the jobs on the ships. And for the medical criteria for ETO, it is similar to GME and marine engineering, okay. As we have already discussed the electrical department and the engine side, now let's talk about the tech side, okay. on the tech side, you have two options to join it. Okay, there are two basic courses that you can do. There is DNS, there is BSc Nautical Science. So let's discuss about BSc Nautical Science. The eligibility criteria for BSc Nautical Science is similar to BTech Marine Engineering. Let's talk about the educational qualification that you need. In 10th or 12th, you have a minimum 50% in English or more. Okay, more is good, but minimum 50% in your English. As we move on to PCM percentage in your 12th, you have to have an aggregate of 60% in your PCM. And for the medical requirement, there is a little difference with the engine side. Okay, your eyes have to be 6x6 or 6x9. That's it. In engine side, there is a little more relaxation, but on deck side, there is no relaxation. As you know, deck side is based on the navigation department. You cannot see properly, how will you navigate a ship? Let's move on to DNS. DNS is Diploma in Nautical Science. It is a 1-year course. And eligibility criteria is similar to BSc Nautical Science. That is to have aggregate of PCM 6. That is to have a 60% PCM aggregate in your 12th. More than 50% marks in English, either in 10th or 12th. And the medical eligibility criteria is similar to BSc Nautical Science. That is, you can find it on Google. Okay, if you want, let us know in the comment section. We are not adding that part in the video because the video will be too large. Okay, so if you want, let us know in the comment section or Google it. It will be a lot easier for you. As we already have discussed all the popular options to join Merchant Navy, let's discuss how can we get a job easily. No, you can get a job, but it is very difficult to get a job these days. So how can we get a job easily? Let's talk about BTech Marine Engineering and BSc Nautical Science. For BTech and BSc student, BTech Marine Engineering student and BSc Nautical Science student, first of all, go for sponsorship. It's my recommendation. You can do it either way, your choice, okay? But these are my suggestions to do if you want to do BSc Nautical Science or BTech Marine Engineering. Go for sponsorship. There is only one college that provides sponsorship, okay? Sponsorship is a new term for you. Sponsorship is a guarantee provided by the company. Okay, they provide a guarantee that for this certain amount of time, they will provide you the sailing or the training there. Okay, that's the trick. If you do well, they will continue. If you do bad, they will leave you. Okay, that's it. Or they might change something. But in Merchant Navy, sailing or training is very, very important. If you get the training, you can give the further examination. If you don't have any training or sailing experience, you cannot give further examinations. And by clearing the further examination, you can apply in the different jobs or different companies. Okay, so even if your company drops you, you have other options too. Okay, so as I have already discussed, go for sponsorship. That's good. If you do not have sponsorship, these are my list for BTech Marine Engineering. That is first time you Kolkata, then Tulani Maritime Institute. For BSc Nautical Science, first TMI, then IMU Navi Mumbai, then IMU Chennai. These are the three options there if you want to go for BSc Nautical Science. Now let's talk about DNS, ETO and GME. These are the three programs. Many companies will open their sponsorship form for these courses, for ETO, DNS and GME. So if you want to do these courses, these are certificate courses or a 1-year course or 6-month course, please do not do them without any sponsorship. They don't have any meaning in the regular or offshore jobs. If you go in some random shop or company, like let's say Infosys, you have this diploma, they will not give you any job on the basis of that. So these certificate courses or diploma courses are useless if you do not have sponsorship. You will get a job, okay, don't worry about it. There are many, but it's very hard, okay. If you do not have a sponsorship, it is very hard for a DNS student to get a job, because as you already know, there's so many people who are doing DNS every year. If you have a sponsorship, whenever you enter the college, you know that after completing my course, I will have a job. Okay, for GME, ETO and DNS, many companies in February batch in DNS, nearly 500-600 students get sponsorship. For ETO and GME, I don't have the data, but many companies and many different companies provide sponsorship, like MSC Fleet Management, Great Eastern, Anglo Eastern, Sims, and all other companies that will provide sponsorship to these students or this program students. Okay, so please go through these websites and have a sponsorship before joining these courses. That's my personal suggestion. You can do it without sponsorship too if you want to. Okay,
diploma in marine engineering, I would not suggest to do it. It's my personal choice, okay? If you want to do it, go for it. But there is only one college that is good for this diploma in marine engineering, that is NUSI Goa. You can contact them and they will let you know all the details about how to join their course and all the things, okay? One more thing I would like to suggest all the UG students is that you should prepare for IIME CET. As I have already mentioned, IIME Kolkata, IIME Navi Mumbai, IIME Chennai and TMI. These are the colleges that will require your IIME CET rank, and you have to have a good rank to specially get IIME Kolkata, IIME Chennai and IIME Navi Mumbai. TMI has their own exam and IIME CET is a little bit part of it, because all the major institutes are affiliated to IIME. Yeah, one more thing, please do not join those colleges that are not affiliated to IIME. My personal suggestion, you can join IIMT University, they are also not affiliated to any IIME, but most of the colleges that are not affiliated to IIME are not very very good, okay? Now let's talk about less popular ways to join Merchant Navy, okay? So these are the two kind of jobs, GP rating and there is a crew and you know cooking department. For the GP rating, you have to do a GP rating course. The best college for that is TS Rahman, okay? Placements are good there, so you can go and do your GP rating from TS Rahman. It's a very good college. So basic educational eligibility criteria to do GP rating is that you have to have minimum 40% in your 10th and 40% in English, okay? That's it. Minimum 40% marks in English and 40% in your 10th aggregate, okay? Overall percentage should be more than 40%. But I would not suggest to at least have 70%, okay? Because competition is going higher. There are very few chances for you to get DS Rahman, okay? In GP rating, you can also join, you know, both sides, engine side and tech side. For engine side, you can become a fitter, motorman and a wiper. For tech side, you can become an able seaman, bosun, ordinary seaman and a fitter. So able seaman and an ordinary seaman, there are two options too. Next is stew and chief cook. Okay, these are people who are responsible for all the catering and the food on the ship, okay? To become a stew and a chief cook on a ship, we have to do a CCMC course. The best college to do CCMC course is TS Rahman or NUSI. The eligibility criteria to do CCMC course is similar to GP rating, 40% marks in 10th and minimum 40% marks in English too. Like minimum 40% in 10th and minimum 40% marks in English in your 10th standard. That's the basic eligibility criteria to do CCMC course. And if you talk like this, if you want to do the CCMC course, you have to give entrance exam, then interview, then admission, then you can go sailing, you know, and all other things. The age limit for CCMC and GP rating course is 17.5 years to 25 years. As you all know, we have to be 18 years old to do international work, okay? So that's minimum 17.5 years. That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I am Sridhar Aspirant signing off.